I actually want to start tonight on quite a sad note. After 4 years, I've decided to retire from long distance marathons. I had a good run. Let's give me a cheer from Cheltenham.
Hey!
Not many. Give me a cheer from Gloucester.
Hey!
Give me a cheer from anywhere else.
Yay!
Okay, I'll try this trick. So, man from Cheltenham and a man from Gloucester stuck in a cave. And the man from Gloucester goes, "Echo! Echo! Echo!" The man from Cheltenham goes, "Citizen!" So I went to a restaurant the other day and I was shocked because everyone was masturbating. I look at the waiter and I go, "What's going on?" He said, "It's first come, first served." The worst thing was there were kids' menus. No. I want to give you all some advice. When you're in bed with your partner, don't mention to them that you work at IT. It's a massive turn off and on again. Speaking of relationships, my friend just got engaged to his car. It all ended in tires. I recently bought a dog. Went to the pet shop. I was scanning my dog for the self-checkout. Because that's how it works in my head. It was really difficult because it was a Dalmatian. And so I was scanning the dog for the checkout and I put it down. Not like that. I place my dog to the side. And then I get this horrible notification that everyone knows. Unexpected item in the wagging area. So I took my dog to the dentist, the dog dentist, and he was so excited because there were so many canines. And afterwards the dentist said, "Oh, shall I share you with the leave?" I knew the Labradoras. That was rough. Last week, I went to this restaurant that only serves chewing gum. And I was shocked because everyone was masticating. I look at the waiter and I go, "What's going on?" So it's first gum, first served. My friend asked me, "Can you do a pun based on flightless birds?" I said, "It's a bit of a stretch." And then he said to me, "Can you do a pun based on spice and fish?" So it's time and place. Do you know who's great? Alexander Byrne. I really admire the length swims will go. You will not believe how easy it is to convince Americans that we pronounce it New Zealand. Now I want to end on a poem tonight. It's my 22nd gig. I've been doing stand-up for just over a year now, so I'm quite good. I want to end on a poem that means a lot to me. A man died and went to heaven. And when he woke up, he was on a beach. And on this beach, he saw two sets of footprints. One belonging to him, and one belonging to Chewbacca. And the man looked up these footprints. And as he walked up, memories of his life came flashing before him. And he was so happy and so pleased that he could share these moments with himself, but also he could share them with Chewbacca. Then the man noticed something very strange. Yes, Chewbacca was here during the really good moments of his life, but there were dark times in his life as well. He was very upset because during the really horrible and sad moments of his life, there was only one set of footprints in the sand. And the man couldn't believe it. So he called down Chewbacca. And he said, "Chewbacca, I love you. I'm so grateful for all the times you were here during the great parts of my life, but as you can see in these really difficult points, there's only one set of footprints in the sand." Chewbacca looks at him. He places a paw on the corner. Pulls him in for a hug. And Chewbacca says,